you notice you've reached your 5-year mark or your 4-year mark, and you notice your locks are now thinner. It's not that the locks are thinner per se. Yes, they are, but it's because they're compressing. They're not going to be that nice, fluffy, textured loveliness that you had as a baby locker. Now you're entering the teenage phase and the locks are getting thinner, aka compressing. Combat that thin lock problem by combining. If you don't want the look that is coming in, combine your locks. But as you're combining, make sure that you're combining ones that can handle the weight. You know, you have to test them, twist them together, and maybe put a rubber band at the end. Wear them like that for a day or two and see if it's weighing down too much. If it's not, then you can go ahead and combine. If it's too heavy, then you cannot combine those. You just have to deal with what you have or start over again with another set of locks. Pruning is another reason why locks thin out. You may not notice. You go to your hairdresser and you have her, you know, cut off those stray hairs on your lock, along your lock, and you do that periodically. You go to get your hair groomed, but as you're doing that, pruning does cause the lock to look thinner and also sometimes to become thinner, because sometimes people make a mistake when they're going in and out with that scissor, and you can weaken the lock because you're picking into the lock with the scissor. Even though you palm roll it back into place, you're weakening and thinning out the lock. So that could be another culprit. Now on to the not so obvious reasons for thinning. One of the biggest ones is stress. I know you're gonna say, oh, I don't have stress right now, you know, I'm okay. But remember, the signs of stress can come anywhere from 2 to 3 to 6 months down the line after the stress has been resolved. Then you will see hair, you know, starting to thin and shed, etc. Even though you've resolved the situation, just know that that's what you're going to get. And the only way to combat that, you dealt with the stress, but you have to give your hair time, as much time as it took for the stress to come on, you have to give yourself enough, the same amount of time for it to come off. Make sure you do your little exercise or sex or hobbies that you enjoy, etc. Now, if you've had stresses, could be having a baby, which is joyous, but it's still stressful to your hair. The hair may not shed into the lock anymore. It will shed out of the lock and cause the lock to look thinner. The new hair that's coming in to be thinner because it's shedding out as opposed to in. So joyous occasions can also bring stress. But if you have stresses like a breakup, etc., make sure that you combat one of the major causes of stress-related thinning, which is sleep. Get your sleep. Overprocessing and dyeing locks can cause your locks to thin out. You can combat this, of course, by trying your best not to color so much, or find a gentler colorant and not color so much, or find a natural colorant such as henna, etc., and maybe that will combat some of the thinness, because you know henna is supposed to thicken out those strands and make them healthier with protein, etc. Another sneaky one is that, okay, you do not process your hair very often, but when you do process your hair, when you color your hair, you do not wash that dye out often. And I was very, very guilty of this. And yes, it does cause thinning of the locks. If all of that product, if all of that dye is not out of your hair, you will experience thinning. Your hairstyle can cause thinning. If you pull your hair back a lot, you might get thinning along the edges. If you pull your hair back a lot and you apply a tight rubber band or casing, etc., you're going to get thinning along that area. If you curl, crinkle your hair a lot and it's stressing the same points of your locks, you're going to experience thinning, or not so much thinning, but compressing in those areas. It's not so much sometimes that the hair is thinning out, but it's compressing in those areas. So some will look fat, then a little thin, then fat, etc. But if you're pulling your hair back, all of that is going to get thinned out. Rubber bands are another sneaky cause of thinning of the locks, especially the ones you put at the ends of your locks. There's no reason for you to do more than two rotations, you know, two tyings of the rubber bands at the ends of your hair. You do more than that and you keep it in for a week or two in a style, you will get thinning and stress in those areas where you have that rubber band tied more than two times, because it's too tight. It's constricting the lock too much and it's going to cause thinning. Over twisting your locks will cause thinning also. Yes, you want your hair to look like locks. You want the hair to lock, so maybe you're constantly fiddling with it. Maybe sometimes you're in class or something and you're there, you know, playing with your lovely hair, but that will cause thinning at the roots, and as it grows out and you keep that practice, the hair growing in will become thin. Scalp conditions like seborrheic dermatitis, do not play around with that. If you don't have professional help dealing with that, you need to go and take care of it, because just doing your own concoctions is not going to work. You have to seek a professional, because it will continue to thin those locks. And last but not least, yes, a change in your diet will thin your locks. Yes, because it's another form of stress, even though it's a good stress, especially if you're changing your diet for the better. You're recalibrating, so to speak, your system. So your system needs time to adjust to that. So the adjustment period, within that adjustment period, you may experience thinning via the locks, the hair shedding out of the locks, etc., until your body can get used to that regimen. But don't stop though. But just know, you know, don't get too stressed out. You know what's happening. Combat it by adding more fruits and vegetables and proteins and irons, especially fortified cereals, to your regimen so that you can combat some of the problems. And just remember, guys, if you have any of these stresses or any of these problems that occur, if you notice them, that caused the thinning, just as much time as it took to cause the thinning, it may take that much time to correct the problem.